urban ecology is essential for a resilient future. If we don't start getting everyone more eco-literate, more engaged in citizen science, more understanding the importance of biodiversity, we are not going to persist as a human species. We've got to make these little islands because more and more people are living in urban areas. And in fact, 70% of Native Americans now live in urban areas. I learned about the Presidio back in 1994 when the military base, the Army, was decommissioning and the plans were underway to convert it to a new type of urban national park. I started as kind of a mediator with Ohlone leaders, and I just served as an advocate and said, we can't talk about the future of the Presidio land without talking about its history and its past. And history did not start in 1776 with Spanish missionization and militarization. It goes back 10,000 years with Ohlone villages and shell mounds and history and communities living all around this area. We started protecting archaeological sites that are located here. We would remove, of course, scotch broom and a lot of the invasive species. We were planting oaks. So there's a lot of coastal dune species that also had medicinal value and cultural value for the Ohlone people. And today they're just gorgeous. They bring back the pollinators, the habitats, then the animals can come and arrive. This place is a refugia. It's a little oasis for urban wildlife. I'm just happy that the Ohlone people now can tell their own story about their histories and have influence on what gets interpreted in the visitor center, public programs. They're consulted whenever you have to do development here. So that's very meaningful that Native people speak for ourselves, that we have voice, that we can assert our traditional knowledge and help manage the ecosystem. To me, it's a sign of decolonization, demilitarization, and regeneration.